Hello, welcome back. In this section, we'll talk about the DEX. So what is the DEX? I have a very brief definition of the DEX. It says, it's the crude admin interface for managing the entire system. It can be accessed by system users, permitted by roles and permission. From the documentation, official documentation, using this link, the Frappy framework comes with a rich admin interface called the DEX. It reads metadata from doc type and automatically build list, view, forms, and wherever. What it does, it helps you manage the entire system from an admin point of view or using an admin interface. The Frappy DEX is made up of various or several features that helps you in managing the system. First, before we go into all this, so in this section, we'll discuss what views are provided by DEX and how to configure them. First off, what is the DEX and how do we use it? When you log in to the Frappy framework you installed, the admin, once you are logged in, you'll be taken to the DEX because you're an administrator. Be sure you are logged in with your admin account. This page you landed on is the DEX. If you installed ERP next, once you log in, you'll be taken to this link with whatever your URL is /DEX. The first landing page when you are logged in is called the DEX. It contains some menu at the left side for the version 13. But for version 12, you only have some kind of buttons here. But for the now, the DEX is made up of buttons at the left side, the shortcut buttons, some other report charts, and this awesome bar with few other buttons here. That is a Frappy DEX or admin interface. The features of the Frappy DEX. First, we have workspace. And what is workspace? The page defines workspace. So when you log in, you are presented with the DEX. It features a persistent site bar sorted in categories. The workspace represents a module, for example, customer relationship manager in ERP Next. So without much ado, I'll go straight into what workspace is. For example, I'll open this users. When you click on this link or any link on this left hand side, you'll be presented with some information. On the page, you can find a chart, then these shortcuts buttons that leads you to each of the information, and this one at the bottom, this is called the reports and masters. So a workspace is made up of charts, shortcuts, and reports relating to a doc type. Later in the course, we'll know what a doc type is. That's the first for a workspace. The next is the awesome bar. What do we do with the awesome bar? It helps you to locate anything on the system as long as that thing exists in the system. This here is the awesome bar. You can type in anything here. For example, I do not know the link to click on to get to a particular information on the system. For example, this user's. I don't know how to get to this user or row, this row here. I simply type in row. It's going to provide some information pertaining to what you type. This is row list, row report, new row, row profile, wherever. Clicking on it takes you to the exact information you search for. So that's what the awesome bar is for. You use it to search for information on the system. If you do not know where or how to get to it directly with the shortcut link. Next is a list view. This list view is used for generating information. It's more like a table. I could call it a HTML table or a Bootstrap table used for listing information. Without further ado, open, for example, this user. Clicking on user, on this shortcut user, takes you to a link with the user. After it, you have this list. The list shows you all the information recorded in this user information or user model or user doc type. You can have every user sorted by the last first, then the first at the bottom. If this exists 20 based on the selection here, it will be paginated into different pages. Sorry about that. That's what the list stands for. And from this list view, You can create new information pertaining to that document. You can delete, you can select all and have several information you can work on. Several other things pertaining to the document. The next on the deck is the form view. This form view is where you create your information. On clicking on new, sometimes you get this shortcut. If you select shortcuts, quick entry while creating the doc type. But for example, I'm going to click on this edit in full page. This is the form view. It enables you to make entry into the system. For every doc type you create, you'll be able to, it will generate, the CRUD or the DEX will generate a form for you to fill in information to be saved into the system. And next is this report builder. Report builder enables you to generate readable information about each document. For example, how do you get reports or information about the users on the system? You click on the user, click on this left hand side to generate the reports, click on report builder. You get a detailed information about it. You can export this information as PDF, Excel, or whatever. You can always preview or check back to get more information about it. But for now, we are going through a quick preview about what this information at the top stands for. This for the now, we'll stop at the report, the tree view, calendar, Gantt, and Kanban. We'll get to that in later videos, but for the now, I would like us to concentrate on this workspace, awesome, but lazy form view. So to recap, workspace is each menu on this left side. Once you click it, what it shows you is the workspace pertaining to that menu or module. Then the awesome bar is this form here that enables you to search on the system. The lazy view helps you view information and create new information about the documents. Form view enables you to make entry and report enables you to see detail view. So that's it for now. We'll move on to the next. Thanks for watching.